Social media can be a valuable tool to spread the word about your acting projects or content, but you have to be smart and savvy about how you promote yourself if you actually want to get results. If we haven't met, I'm Heidi Dean, social media expert for actors, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to avoid the five biggest self-promotion mistakes that actors make every single day. Hit that like button if you're excited. Let's do this. The first self-promotion mistake I see actors make all the time is that you only use social media for promotion. We all have that friend who goes from never posting on social media to posting 10 times a day about their recent gig. Let me know in the comments if you have a friend like this. And hey, that friend may be you. Social media is not just for promotion. Your social media should be a mix of three types of posts. You're gonna wanna write this down. First type of posts are brand building posts. These help us get to know the behind the scenes of you as a human and an actor. The second type of posts are community posts. These types of posts help you engage your audience and get to know them. And the third type of post are those self-promotional posts. To be successful on social media, you should be juggling these three types of posts: brand building, community, self-promotion. Brand building, community, self-promotion. They don't have to be in equal amounts, but you shouldn't just be juggling one ball. But that's what some of you are doing. You're only juggling those self-promotional posts and nothing else. You're not creating posts that help us get to know you better, or posts that help you get to know your audience better. And I'm sure you've experienced this. When we see someone that does this all the time, we start to tune them out in the feed. We see their post and we just scroll on by. And if you're not my BFF, then there is a chance that I might actually unfollow you or mute you. So starting today, I want you to juggle these three types of posts. Now, if you only post self-promotional things, I've got something for you in the description below. It's totally free, 30 days of post ideas for actors, and they lean more toward the brand building and the community posts. So definitely get that before we're done today. A second self-promotion mistake I see a lot of you making is what I call spaghetti posting in Facebook groups. Facebook groups, LinkedIn groups, these can be valuable tools to help spread the word about your content. However, you need to personalize your messages. And what I see some of you doing is cutting and pasting the same message in numerous groups. So you'll drop it in Woohoo Wednesday somewhere, share your post Saturday, Flaunted Friday, Shameless Self-Promotion Sunday, and you'll drop the same post everywhere without customizing it for that individual audience. Think about it. Every Facebook group you're in is slightly different with a slightly different audience. The group leaders might also call their group members by a certain name. In my Social Savvy Actor Facebook group, a lot of people write posts, "Hey Savvy Actors," or maybe it's in the Talent Managers for Actors group, "Hey TMFA," or in the Think Bigger Tribe, "Hey Tribe members." Customize your posts so it fits the language of the group. Make it more personal. The other big mistake I see you making in Facebook groups is giving us no context for the link you're dropping. So it may be on a Share Your Stuff Saturday, you just drop a link to see your YouTube video or for us to check out your stuff, but you don't even write a post telling us why we should go take a look. Or you make a generic announcement, "Go check out my latest YouTube video," or "Go check out my latest web series episode," without telling us what's in it for me. There are so many links being dropped in Facebook groups. Why should I care? Why is this video worth my time? You will get so many more people clicking on your link in a Facebook group if you tell us what it's about, who it's for, and what's in it for them. The third promotional mistake that you need to stop today is sending cut and paste direct messages to lots of people telling them to go watch your stuff. Now, when I receive a direct message from someone I rarely ever speak to that doesn't have my name, chances are it is a cut and paste generic message that they're just trying to send to as many people as possible. That's called spam, guys. You're basically saying, "I don't care who you are. All I care about is the number of views I get on my new video or the number of tickets I sell for my next show." If you are going to utilize your direct messages on Twitter or Instagram for promotion, make sure you personalize them. Truly, the best way to get anyone's attention is to appeal to their ego. And the easiest way to do that is to simply use their name. So personalize those direct messages. You're more likely to get someone clicking over to watch your stuff, and you're more likely to get a true subscriber and fan that's gonna stick around for the next video. Number four, another big self-promotion no-no that I see is that you're talking at us instead of talking with us in your post. Social media is social. It's in the name. It's about communicating with your audience, not at your audience. Most actors use social media like this, a megaphone, to broadcast their news at people instead of using it like a telephone to talk with people, to talk with us about their projects. Write this down. Social media is more like a telephone than a megaphone. It's so important. Social media is about conversations. It is a dialogue. And when you make your post a conversation, especially the promotional one, you can actually post about your projects and bookings more often. Why? Because you're actually taking the focus off of yourself and you're making your post a we instead of an all about me, me, me. Now, there's a ton of ways we can do this, but the simplest way to transform any post into a conversation is by turning it into a question. So instead of saying, watch my web series for the 10th time this week, why not ask, what's your favorite episode this season? Or what do you think Sam's gonna do next week? Now, that post doesn't seem promotional at all, even if it's about your content. It's more community building. Asking a question prompts a dialogue with your followers. And there is a great side effect to making your post a conversation. Your engagement will go up. If you wanna beat any social media algorithm, make sure your posts are more like a telephone than a megaphone. Got it? And promotional mistake number 5 is that you're posting with your blinders on. Now, when we get in self-promotion mode, especially as an artist, you want views, you want to sell tickets, you want to get butts in the seats, we tend to have blinders on. And our posts get a little selfish and all about us. Now, many moons ago, when I was a teenager, I remember my mom would look at me and say, Heidi, you gotta take the blinders off. You're not thinking about anybody else but you. You're not seeing anything around you. Take the blinders off. And over time, all she'd have to do is say, take the blinders off. And then over time, she would just look at me like this, and I knew exactly what she meant. I was only thinking about myself. And I see some of you guys doing the same thing with your promotional posts. A very simple way to take these blinders off on social media is what I call posting with gratitude. When posting about a project you're working on or you worked on in the past, instead of always just talking about yourself, make someone else the subject of your post. The subject of your post can be your followers, your fans, a fellow cast member, the director, or the whole project. It could be as simple as, it was such an honor to work with this person, or thank you for including me in the project. Posting with gratitude. And posting with gratitude works every single time if you're doing it authentically. Why? Because the post is no longer about you, it's about them. You've taken those blinders off, my mom would be proud. So there you have it, 5 ways to fix the biggest self-promotional mistakes I see actors making every day. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and make sure you subscribe to my channel for more marketing tips for actors. And if you need those free post ideas, grab them right here. And here's another resource to help you with your social media. Until next time, I'll see you on social. Bye.